I think it's recognizing that you have circles of influence in your life, and the circle that's the closest is the one that has the most influence on you. And those are the friends and family members, hopefully, that are pursuing Jesus the same way that you're pursuing Jesus, because those are going to be the ones most influential. But then you kind of have concentric circles going out from there of different levels of friendship, where you're being purposeful in choosing how much influence those people are going to have in your life.
I think part of it is kind of like, you know, how a valve system works. You know, you've got a valve system in pipes that allow water to go out, but not to back up in the pipe. And in some ways, I think our relationships work that way. We've got some relationships in which we need to, and we should allow things to flow in both directions, where we receive and we give out. But there are other areas of relationship where we need to understand that the only thing that's safe for us in those is to be giving out, yeah, and not letting things come back in from some sources. Well, I mean, the whole matter of relationships and how you touch people that are outside of the faith is really at the heart of what we want to be doing at Living Stones Church. Because the whole idea of church is not to come into some cloistered environment, you know, where you're attending groups together and you're an audience, you know, on a Sunday morning, participating in worship even, but rather the idea is we do come together regularly. I mean, on Sundays for worship in small groups, but the purpose behind coming together in one manner of speaking is so that we go out, so that we infiltrate the community, so that we're leaven. The purpose of Living Stones Church is to be a missions base in the islands of Hawaii, to be able to go out and extend the kingdom of God in this community, to love the city where God has placed us and to seek the good of that city. And that means seeking the good for those who are Christian and non-Christian, and in the process of it, introducing them to Jesus. I think one of the cultural values that we'd like to see at Living Stone is that we are all called to be missionaries, that if you're a believer, if you're a follower of Jesus, you are a missionary. And that does not mean you give up your job, your vocation, but rather you start understanding that any area where God has called you is the mission field to which He's called you. And so having this sense where the church is a missions base from which we go out and do that work in missions, whether you're a sales clerk at Macy's or Kmart, or whether you are a doctor or a lawyer or an accountant. I mean, it doesn't matter what your job is. It's a sphere of influence and a mission field that God has called you to, and being intentional about how you move into that with a sense of calling, you know, from God on that job that He's given you.